Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Voxley's. Thanks for coming out tonight. Super excited to be here with these fine individuals. You're listening to Mr. Jared Hall on the trumpet, Steve Tressler on the tenor saxophone, Michael Glynn on the bass, Greg Williamson on the drums. I'm Danny Kolke. We are the Voxley Quintet, and it's been a while since we've played together as a collective. Jared now is on the other side of the mountains, so it's good to have you back. That first tune, we're going to do a bunch of originals for you. That first tune is a really simple blues tune that I wrote when I was stuck in Columbus, Ohio. It's called Columbus O. It's the name of the song, so there you go. Yeah, I was on a business trip, and I got stuck there, and I went out to dinner, and the restaurant was really insulted by my dietary needs and told me I should call in advance. And I said, I'm stuck here. I didn't know I was going to be here. So I wrote that tune sitting at the table. And just like the riff came to me and I go, hey, it's really simple. Let's do it. So anyways, that's Columbus. So we're going to move on in our program with another tune called Moving On. This is also an original. Hope you enjoy it. Yeah, double check that. Yeah, last time I handed a handwritten chart. It's, isn't that beautiful? So, and halfway through, I forgot to transpose it for him. So that was fun. This is fixed. Hey, this is a waltz. I love waltzes. We might do more than one tonight. This is loosely based on the chord changes of another very popular tune with a different twist at the end of it. So I hope you enjoy it. I call this I Will Wait For You. Thank you.
try new music.
We're practicing right now.
And just start by vamping the first eight songs, okay?
Yellow letter out of us.
So Jared emailed me and said, hey, can you print this tune? So we're going to play it for you. I just told him to yell a letter at us if he needs to. So this is an original by Jared Hall. How about a hand for Jared? Steve Tressler. Yeah. All right. So this is a brand new tune from Jared Hall. So looking forward to playing it here. Thank you. Hometown. Let's do... So for you numbers people, you get to count how many beats there are in this one, okay? Yeah, the whole thing, man. It's simple math, right? How many measures, right? Start counting. So this is, I write tunes different ways. This tune, I sat down one day, and I was just, had this cadence in my brain, and like many piano players, I like write tunes and in keys that I don't feel like I'm very good at playing in, so then I'll learn how to play in that key, right? So this is one of those things. I just sat down and started playing this quick cadence of chords, and I go, oh, I like that. So I whipped out my phone and recorded it, and I go, okay, I'll just play this little riff on it, and I go, I'll write that down later. And then I sat down to write it, and I go, wait, this is not in 4/4. I never write tunes in an odd meter. And then when I wrote it down, I realized it's backwards. You never do tunes in 7 like this, right? You always do 4 + 3. Oh, I'm sorry. Never 3 + 4. I gave away the thing. Anyways, this is a tune I wrote during the pandemic. I spent a lot of time in this room during the pandemic. And this tune I call Everything's Gonna Be Okay. Thank you.
Oh, okay, got it. Thank you. How about we do another waltz? Let's close with a waltz. Let's do, can we do that? We could do, I was thinking only for today, 91.
Okay.
291.
All right, so this tune, this is another pandemic song, but written for a different purpose. So I lost my father that year due to cancer, and thankful that I got to spend a lot of time with him those last few months. And we had lots of talks about how much time do I have left, you know? And this was a recurring theme. The title of the song was, well, we don't know how much time we have. You know, an accident could happen. Anything could happen. But we know we have today. So this song is dedicated to my dad, and it's called Only for Today.
Thank you.
Jared Hall on the trumpet. Steve Tressler on the tenor saxophone. Greg Williamson on the drums. Michael Glenn on the bass. I'm Danny Kolke. Hey, stick around. We're going to take a set break, and we'd like to have you stick around. And also, before you go, I need to say a couple things. All the music we do here is supported by Jazz Clubs Northwest. We are a 501c3 nonprofit. We've been doing this here in North Bend. We're working on our 14th year, believe it or not. So we need your support to keep doing that. And we do lots of cool things. We have a couple events coming up I want to tell you about. So first is next Wednesday. We're bringing out Ollie Jackson and his trio. Ollie was Wynton Marsalis' drummer for many years with the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. He's now touring on his own, and we've had him before, and it's an amazing show. That's next Wednesday. It's a special event, so get tickets for that. That's not our normal programming night. You can just go on our website, and there's a link. The other thing is April 22nd. Mark your calendars. We take over the entire town, and there are 18 jazz clubs in North Bend that night. For the this will be the – well, we skipped a couple years. This would have been the 12th North Bend Jazz Walk. Instead, it's the 10th. So there you go. Yeah, a couple of ghost walks in there. So super excited for that. That's April 22nd. So northbendjazzwalk.com is the website for that. So stick around. We'll look forward to seeing you in the second set. Danny Kolke sitting in on piano. Thanks, Danny. And once again, that was Bunny by Jerry Mulligan. And I was remiss in not mentioning that this
live stream is brought to you by jazzclubsnw.org, Jazz Clubs Northwest, a nonprofit organization that does a whole lot for jazz education as well as live jazz performance. And please think about being a sustaining member, just like you would for National Public Radio or anything else that you feel is an important part of your life. You can go to their website, jazzclubsnw.org. You may be watching this right now from that very website. Great organization, and Danny Kolke puts that all together with Boxley's down here. And also come down to Boxley's almost every Thursday night, Friday night, Saturday night. Usually there's big band action, helmed by Greg Williamson many times. Usually the Pro-Am big band is scrunched in here. Or the Pony Boy All-Star Big Band, which just played the music of Kenny Wheeler, what, about a week ago or something like that. So look for those. There's all sorts of, and I believe Ollie Jackson is coming here at some point, too. So there's, and Jeff Hamilton's trio has been here. So this is right here in North Bend, Washington, our very own little slice of Greenwich Village.
Yeah.
It's just like Smalls and Mesro's, you know, so. Come on down. I think actually the video quality and audio quality is a little better than Smalls, because I listen to both of these streaming things all the time. So, we've got one last tune. Yeah, this should do it. It's a very fast one, though. We're going to have to play some long solos on this one, I think. This is one that was from the Jerry Mulligan, Bob Brookmeyer recording. There's a live recording at the Storyville Jazz Club and in Boston. And yeah, with George Ween, the guy that ran the Newport Jazz Festival, that was his club. And there's a great live recording. And on Facebook, you may have noticed some of the posts. Greg put a post up there. Heather shared a post. And Matzo. There was he alluded to that there was a story, a Jerry Mulligan story, but he's not going to tell it now. I was actually at that. It was the Cool Jazz Festival in Mary Moore Park in the early 80s, probably, right? Like
81?
81, yep. I remember seeing that, and where a little bit of Mr. Mulligan's Irish temper kind of came to the fore. And it also does on that live recording. If you listen to it, it's available on streaming. You can listen to Spotify or YouTube or whatever, iTunes. And I forget which tune it is.
The last one's Limelight, I think.
Oh, Limelight? Oh, okay. There's one where where there's a guy whistling. It's a very loud, kind of loud audience that's happening at the time, and listening along, what's some tune that they knew? So I was, you hear this whistle?
No, it was just a high pitch.
It was a high whistle, but they're trying to, I think they're trying to whistle the tune along with it. It ended up being more like a Keith Jarrett kind of thing. And and so you hear Mulligan just say, that's really, will you knock it off? He just stops soloing a couple times, and then he addresses the person in the audience about that. And it's captured forever on vinyl and now on streaming, so you can hear that on here. And this was the ending. This was the last, their closing tune, because it's a fast one. And he tells a quick story about being in Paris, and they get some bicycles. And they're like, is there a river or the Strand?
Paris? That's the Seine.
It's the Seine, not the Strand. But he talks about biking up the Strand. This is actually a tune that's based on Strike Up the Band by George Gershwin. But he calls it Bike Up the Strand. And it's a fast one. So we're going to close off with this one, and that's, once again, Matzo Limtiako on the baritone saxophone, Greg Williamson on the drums, and his better half, Heather Chris Caden on the bass, and I'm Brent Jensen on the alto saxophone. Thanks for listening, and come down to Boxley's or listen to the live stream every week. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Live. Remember asking Greg at a clinic with a bunch of kids, hey, what's a good way to end a tune? And he goes, stop playing. That's what just happened right there. Hey, that was a tune written last Friday as our guest artist that night was walking in the door, and I was just playing that little riff. And he goes, hey, we should play that as a tune. And so we did. We decided to do it as a blues tune. And then he handed the mic to me, and he goes, what's it called? I go, we just wrote it. It's like, I don't know, Little Diddy. So how about Little Diddy Blues? So that's what we called it, Little Diddy Blues. Hey, we're going to do an original by our bassist, Mr. Michael Glenn. For those of you following along in your program, it's number 45. This is called Horace Play. Michael Glenn. Chorus play. Hey, we got a couple more for you. Let's do 90s. This is a ballad, for those of you music nerds. One of the things I like to do is have my students play 2-5-1s in all 12 keys. So what better thing to do when your wife leaves you for a few weeks on a Sea Scout trip than write a song about her in all 12 keys? So that's what this is. That's Love, and appropriately titled, When Will I See You Again? It's dedicated to my beautiful bride who's in the back of the room right now. So, Robin. Thank you. Okay, we're going to do a burner for you to close out the night. This is sort of a contrafact, sort of not. Sort of something about friends and lovers no more. But it's got an extended thing. So I call it Forget That. So it's got some hoops in it, yeah. Boops. Steve Tressler on the tenor sax. Jared Hall on trumpet. Greg Williams on the drums. Michael Glenn on the bass. I'm Danny Kulke. And this is Forget That. Thank you. Jared Hall, Steve Chesler, Greg Williamson, Michael Glenn. I'm Danny Kolke. Hey, thanks for coming out and sticking around with us. Remember to check out Ollie Jackson. Next Wednesday. And then the Jazz Walk on April 22nd. So come on out again. We'll see you then. Thanks.